but I don't have the beard kind of thing. No, I'm not Hasan Minhaj. So I bumped into a friend the other day, and he basically is panicked and freaking out simply because somebody told him he's got hepatitis and he's convinced he's going to die. Well, I said, look, what do you know about hepatitis? He said, look man, the liver is all wrong, the liver tests are abnormal and that's it. I said, okay, well hold on a second. Basically, if you break down what hepatitis is such, HEPA basically means liver, itis means inflamed. All it means is your liver is inflamed. Now it could be so many different reasons why it's inflamed, including autoimmune conditions, alcohol could do it, lots of viruses can do it, even medication can cause your liver to get inflamed. The thing is this, is that you need to know what's causing it to know what to fix. And common reasons for hepatitis, especially the viral reasons, are things like hepatitis A, B, C, D, E. Now, importantly, remember is that A and E are often related to contaminated food. D you cannot have unless you have B. B is often transmitted from mother to child, and B and C are often transmitted via blood. This friend of mine further is actually more concerned about hepatitis B, and his family has had it, or as he put it, but actually they probably still have it as you go. Now, hepatitis B is a DNA virus, so essentially once it's in you, it's staying there forever. It's not going to disappear or go anywhere. The problem with this virus is that a lot of people have it and don't even know they have it. Now, if you had it at childbirth, it's quite likely you're going to have it. Right? Have chronic hepatitis B, 95% chance it's going to stay there. But if you get it as an adult, you probably have a viral illness for a few weeks and then about 91% chance of you removing it by itself. A chronic state is there when you've had it for more than 6 months. But the thing about this is that it often has no symptoms. I mean, you can get jaundice and liver problems, etc. But most of the time, people don't even know they have this condition. The thing about hepatitis B is such, is that it's a virus that causes inflammation in the liver. Inflammation by itself in short term doesn't, or most of the time doesn't really do too much, but long term it causes damages to the liver itself, which then what we worry about is that the constant inflammation to the liver increases your chance of liver cancers tremendously. The deal with hepatitis B is such, is that if your body keeps it in check, and it does, imagine that your body keeps the virus in a box. It stays in the box, it's okay. It's sitting there, yes, you have the virus and you can spread it along, etc. But it's keeping the damage away from you. The problem comes is when this virus control is lost and the box is broken. That's when things can go all wrong. Unsurprisingly, this friend of mine then now asked, what happens when the control is lost? Well, when the control is lost is when things are most dangerous, because the liver gets inflamed and damage is being done. Now, the thing about hepatitis B is this, it's not so much the inflammation that's going on, that's actively going on, that's a problem, but more of the risk it poses to there being cancers in the future. And that's the goal, is to keep liver cancers away by controlling hepatitis B. Now, what can you do about it? There's no magic food or funny drinks that you can have that can solve this. If the control is lost, the control needs to be gained back. How can it be gained back? Often it's with medicines. Most of these medicines, the most common one is tenofovir. It's just a tablet a day. Yes, you may have to be on it for the rest of your life as it stands, but keeps things in check, keeps cancers away. Surely that must be worth something. So most of you will probably know your hepatitis B status. If you're not sure or you're worried about it, it's just a simple blood test. Get it done and then you'll know what to do next. This is Dr. Prabhjot, consultant gastroenterologist, hepatologist and physician. If this information was useful for you, likely it'd be useful for someone else too. So feel free to share it.